Hi, everyone, and welcome to English for You. My name is Joe.
And I'm Mike.
Today, we're talking about a classic children's tale. It's called Charlotte's Web.
Yes.
Yes, we're going to go visit a farm where there are some remarkable creatures that can do some pretty crazy things. I remember reading this story, or maybe even having it read to me as a child. Do you remember this story?
It's a classic. I remember my sister had this book, and I must have heard her reading it or had our parents read it. They made a very popular cartoon movie of it.
Yes.
I think it's still around these days. It's still a family favorite, especially for the little kids. And it's a story about a bunch of, farm animals that have quite an interesting experience. It always reminded me, remember that movie Babe?
Yes.
About the little talking pig? That was many years after Charlotte's Web, I believe. Certainly, I only watched Babe many years after, but it always kind of reminded me in the same kind of sweet way about these, cute little farm animals having an adventure.
That's right. It is a sweet story. It's kind of famous for making people cry sometimes. It's
one of those sad kids' stories.
It's a bit emotional, but I'm sure you all will enjoy our abridged or a shortened version of it, of this classic Western children's tale. Let's go ahead and read through day one of Charlotte's Web right now.
Reading Charlotte's Web. Wilbur the pig was born unlucky. He was born a runt. Mr. Arable, the farmer, wants to kill him. He doesn't think Wilbur will be able to help the farm in any way. However, Mr. Arable's daughter, Fern, stops him as he heads outside with his axe. Fern thinks it's unfair that Wilbur has to die just because he's small. Fern offers to take care of the tiny piglet herself. Later, Mr. Arable decides to sell him to Mr. Zuckerman, a local farmer. Wilbur struggles to make friends until he meets Charlotte, a spider living in his pen. Charlotte cheers Wilbur up by showing him how she spins her web. Over the summer, Wilbur passes the time talking with Charlotte and occasionally visiting with Fern. One day toward Christmas, though, the sheep tells Wilbur that Zuckerman is fattening him up for dinner. That night, Charlotte thinks about how she can save Wilbur from this terrible fate.
Our story begins by saying Wilbur the pig was born unlucky.
Aww.
He was born a runt. Okay, he's unlucky, meaning he has bad luck or bad fortune. He was born a runt. A runt is an animal that is too small, basically. Animals are sometimes born in groups, like they're born in what we call a litter, L-I-T-T-E-R. And usually in every one of those, there's one that is smaller than the rest, and that is called the runt. And usually they are not meant to survive. Unfortunately, they usually die because they are small, they are weak, they can't get as much food as their bigger brothers and sisters can, so they just do not survive. So Wilbur, unfortunately, was the runt of the litter.
Oh, that's too bad. And things might be getting worse for Wilbur as we read. It says Mr. Arable, the farmer, wants to kill him. Oh my gosh. Yeah, for a mother pig and even for a farmer taking care of a young, weak animal or child or baby that might not live to grow up to be an adult is kind of a waste of time and energy. It's a tough kind of math, but if you think about survival and the way that, life goes on like that, it maybe is the right thing to think. So the farmer thinks, well, this pig won't make me much money. He's never going to grow up to be big and strong. So why don't I just, kill him now, and then I won't have to waste money on feeding him. He doesn't think Wilbur will be able to help the farm in any way. So there you go. However, someone disagrees with Mr. Arable. Mr. Arable's daughter, Fern, stops him as he heads outside with his axe. So his daughter, Fern, thinks that Wilbur is cute or something, but she basically doesn't want her father, the farmer, to kill him, and he was going to as he was heading outside with his axe. And an axe is, I guess you could call it a weapon. It's more of a tool. It's the kind of thing you might use to chop down a tree with. So you swing it with one hand or more frequently with two hands. It has a sharp blade on one side at the end of it. And you swing that into the wood and slowly you chip away at that tree and you chop down the tree. Well, it's also a good way to kill a small animal, I would suppose. They used axes to kill kings in Europe a long time ago, so I guess if you're trying to kill a small pig, an axe would do the job.
They also used them, I guess, to kill chickens and
That's
things
true,
like they
yeah.
chop the heads off quickly so the animal doesn't feel anything. And
we should also point out sometimes axe is spelled A-X-E
That's
as
right.
well. I've seen that before.
So he's going to kill Wilbur with an axe, but Fern stops him.
No, Daddy,
now,
no.
Why does Fern stop him? Well, Fern thinks it's unfair that Wilbur has to die just because he's small. Okay, so Fern, she's a child, so she thinks differently than adults do, and she thinks, well, just because he's small, why should he die? It's unfair. It's not fair that he should die just because he's more little than the other animals, the other pigs. So Fern offers to take care of the tiny piglet herself. If you offer something, it means you say that you will do something. Or sometimes we talk about making an offer in the business sense. You can offer to buy or to sell something. In this case, she offers or says that she will take care of the tiny piglet herself. So she says, Dad, you don't have to do anything. I'll do all the work. I'll raise Wilbur. I'll make sure he's healthy and happy and gets all the food and love and attention he needs. So you won't have to do anything. So you don't have to chop off Wilbur's head.
Later, Mr. Arable decides to sell him to Mr. Zuckerman, a local farmer and the owner of Facebook. No, I don't think
Mark
it's...
Mark Zuckerberg.
Zuckerberg. Oh, right. I almost got that wrong, didn't I? So he decides to sell him to another farmer because I guess Wilbur's grown up to be a little bit bigger. He might get some money for him. But Wilbur, well, as many kids do, as many young people, even young pigs do when he moves to a new place, it says he struggles to make friends until he meets Charlotte, a spider living in his pen. Ah, so here is the Charlotte from the title of the story, and now we know why it's Charlotte's Web. Charlotte is a spider. But it was never easy for Wilbur to make friends at the new farm. It said he struggled to make new friends. To struggle is basically to fight, to deal with a difficult situation. Okay, you could struggle with someone if they attack you. Someone tries to steal your phone and you'll fight with them. You'll struggle with them. But we can also struggle more frequently with difficulties in our lives. You can struggle to understand your math homework. Certain older people might struggle to lose weight or quit smoking. And if anyone leaves you, if anyone in your life dies or moves away, you can struggle with missing them. You can struggle with feelings of loneliness and also struggle with making friends if you're a new kid at a school. And that's kind of what Wilbur's struggle was. But he met Charlotte, who lived in his pen. A pen is just that small fenced-in area inside a farm or a barn where each animal will live, kind of like the animal's own little separate room to keep them away from the other animals.
Charlotte cheers Wilbur up by showing him how she spins her web.
Oh, that's nice.
That's very nice of her. She cheers Wilbur up. If you cheer somebody up, it means you do things to make them smile or to make them laugh if they're feeling sad or they're not feeling very good. So you do something to make them feel better, in other words. And the way that she does this is she shows him how she spins her web. To spin something means to move it in a circular motion, like you can spin a ball on the tip of your finger or something like that. We talk about spiders spinning their web because they take the silk thread that comes out of their body and they kind of seem to move it with their arms or their legs in a circular motion to make the web that they live on. The web is that silk that they make into something that looks almost like a net that they will hang up between different things. That you will often see spider webs, say, like in the corners of an apartment sometimes. I know I see them in my apartment if I don't clean often enough. We also call these webs cobwebs sometimes, but we can just say web. It's simpler and certainly easier to spell. So she shows him how she spins her web in order to make Wilbur feel better.
Over the summer, Wilbur passes the time talking with Charlotte and occasionally visiting with Fern. Okay, so it seems he's kind of settled into life on the farm. He passes the time talking with Charlotte and occasionally visiting with Fern. Remember, she's the young girl who sort of saved his life when he was just a wee baby. And so he only visits her, though, occasionally. We use occasionally. It's one of those frequency words to talk about how often or how frequent something happens. Occasionally, I'd say it's like 50% of the time. You know, you might say, oh, I occasionally see movies. I don't see one every month or every weekend, but, you know, once in a while, 2-3 times a year, something like that. So not often, but not rarely, kind of in between. Occasionally, once in a while. All right, so it says he passes time with Charlotte and occasionally with Fern, too. To pass the time or to pass the time of day is basically to spend some time doing something. Doesn't matter what you're doing, but if you sort of put aside a few hours of your day to do that, you are passing the time doing something. It's a shortcut for you, so let's check it out right now.
Shortcut for you.
What is a three-letter word for candy?
Hey, what are you up to?
Oh, nothing. Just passing the time.
Passing the time? How can you pass time?
To pass the time means to spend time doing something.
Gotcha. Pass the time is 打发时间.
That's right. I'm just relaxing and passing the time with this crossword.
Maybe I should find some way to pass the time.
Oh, there are lots of ways to pass the time.
What do you usually do?
Besides crossword puzzles? Well, I like to look at the clouds. Sometimes, I watch grass grow. Other times, I go to department stores and count the lights on the ceiling.
Maybe I'll find another way to pass the time.
And yes, we also had that phrase to visit with somebody. It said that young Wilbur visits with Fern. That's basically just to go and say hi to someone, to spend some time with them, maybe have a coffee, have a chat. We often go and visit with our friends on the weekend when we have some free time.
One day toward Christmas, though, the sheep tells Wilbur that Zuckerman is fattening him up for dinner.
No.
Uh-oh, this looks bad.
Ooh.
We're getting towards Christmas. Christmas means a lot of food. A lot of food,
yes,
on the table. We often have a huge feast. Sometimes we have turkey. Sometimes we have ham. A Christmas ham.
I just realized Wilbur is bacon.
Wilbur is bacon,
ooh,
and we do like bacon.
I like Wilbur, too.
Everybody likes bacon.
I'm so torn.
And a big Christmas ham is a kind of a tradition.
Wilbur, you're so cute, but you're so delicious.
You're so delicious,
oh.
And Zuckerman is fattening him up. If you're fattening someone or something up, it means you are helping them to get fat by eating a lot of food.
You don't usually don't do it to people.
Not usually.
No.
Although there are African tribes where they do
that.
Where they do send the woman off for time to just eat and get fat.
And to get fat.
Because that's what they want. To have a fat wife is considered...
Oh, not to eat her.
Not to eat her.
Oh, good.
No.
Okay.
To marry her. Marry
her. I see.
Her.
Oh, okay. Because, yes, if a woman has more meat on her bones, she'll probably have a healthier child, right?
And it's considered a sign of being rich
as well. Oh, I see. That's true. Yeah.
Because you can have
a lot of extra food and you don't have to work in the fields.
For Wilbur, though, this is not for getting married. This is for getting eaten. So
that's right.
He's getting fattened up by Zuckerman. This is what the sheep is saying. Okay, so this is according to the sheep. Can you trust a sheep?
Nah.
I'm not sure.
No, I don't think so.
He might just be spreading rumors around the farm.
Yeah, that's why they make that noise. Meh, they're always thinking of a lie.
They're dishonest.
While they're doing that. I don't know. I think sheep are generally quite honest. That night, it says, Charlotte thinks about how she can save Wilbur from this terrible fate. So even though she's a spider and he's a Pig, they're really good friends, and she wants to save Wilbur from his terrible fate, or this bad thing that could happen to him. To save someone from something basically means you act in a way that is hopefully going to protect someone or something you like from being hurt, all right? So a fireman might save a person from a fire, an older brother might save their younger brother or sister from being hurt in a fight at school, you know, that kind of thing. You're going to do something to help another person and to protect that other person. In this case, Charlotte is trying to protect or save Wilbur from his terrible fate. Fate is basically like your future, your fortune, what is going to happen to you, your destiny. We often go to fortune tellers, right? People who can read cards or, you know, read numbers to tell you what's going on in your future. They're going to tell you your fate. It could be good, it could be bad, but it hasn't happened yet, but some people believe you know it will, or you can tell if it will. So this is basically what Charlotte's thinking. If I don't do something, he will be eaten. My friend Wilbur will be eaten. I have to try to help him. What a nice spider.
Well, we're going to have to wait to find out what happens to Wilbur in the next couple of days. Right now, though, let's go to our For You chat.
For You chat.
All right, today on the program, we've been talking about our favorite little pig, Wilbur. Mm. And at the end of the program, he got some very bad news that the farmer was fattening him up for Christmas dinner, apparently. So he had to take that news and try to figure out what to do, basically. So that's what our For You chat question is about. I believe everyone has received bad news at some time. Nobody's life is just made up of good news all the time.
That would be boring.
That would be boring, and we'd never know how it feels to feel good, because we just all feel good all the time, really.
Right.
So, Mike, have you ever received some bad news, and explain what happened?
Oh my gosh, I received some terrible news. Of course I have. You know, people close to me being ill or something like that, having friends or family die, when you get that phone call in the middle of the night that something bad's happened to a relative, that's never good. And, you know, there's the more minor things, like, oh, it's going to rain tomorrow, so our trip to the beach has been canceled, or something like that. The restaurant that I love is closed today, or they don't have the food that I want to eat. I think how we handle bad news is the most important thing, because, of course, we can't stop bad news, but we can control how we handle it. So if you get bad news, it's not good to, you know, blame the person who tells you, or feel like the whole world is against you. That's the important thing, because, as you said, Joe, everyone will receive some bad news at least once or twice in their life, but probably more than that.
That's right. And you talk about handling it well. You talk about not blaming the person who gives it to you. We call that shooting the messenger.
Shooting the messenger. Right.
When somebody gives you bad news and it's not their fault, but you get angry and you blame them, even though they're not the one who caused it. So, yes, if you do receive some bad news, handling it well is one of the most important things. You guys can have a chat about this, and we're out of time for today, but we'll be back with more Charlotte's Web tomorrow. Until then, I'm Joe.
I'm Mike.
Goodbye.
Charlotte's Web. Wilbur the pig was born unlucky. He was born a runt. Mr. Arable, the farmer, wants to kill him. He doesn't think Wilbur will be able to help the farm in any way. However, Mr. Arable's daughter, Fern, stops him as he heads outside with his axe. Fern thinks it's unfair that Wilbur has to die just because he's small. Fern offers to take care of the tiny piglet herself. Later, Mr. Arable decides to sell him to Mr. Zuckerman, a local farmer. Wilbur struggles to make friends until he meets Charlotte, a spider living in his pen. Charlotte cheers Wilbur up by showing him how she spins her web. Over the summer, Wilbur passes the time talking with Charlotte and occasionally visiting with Fern. One day toward Christmas, though, the sheep tells Wilbur that Zuckerman is fattening him up for dinner. That night, Charlotte thinks about how she can save Wilbur from this terrible fate.
Vocabulary Review. Axe. Matthew used an axe to chop down the tree. Offer. Roxy offered to take care of the twins so their mother could take a break. Struggle. Colin's been struggling with math. He might stay after school to get the teacher's help. Spin. The students watched a video of a spider spinning its web during science class. Web. The spider uses its web to catch flies and other small insects. Fate. The man got away from the police and disappeared. His fate is still unknown.